Hello everyone. So day three of Inktober, and it's late because I've been at a market selling my prints today. So I'm going to stick to it. It's going to be a quick one. I'm going to sit in my little corner and yeah, just draw a really quick video. Robin's doing her thing. So, okay. I need to set up the camera, and I think I'm just going to draw a little cabin, just because, why not? Okay, so I'm all set up, and it's going to be really quick, really small, and I think I'm going to draw a cabin, so I'm going to go, as it's small, I'm going to go right in. So I'm starting with just a cube and a lot of you will know how to draw a cube in perspective. If you don't, then you can check out the foundation I've done or just follow along. You might pick it up from this video. It's pretty simple, but I'm not going to talk through that all again. Or am I? I don't know, maybe. These are my two vanishing points. That's my horizon line. As long as you got that, you can draw in 2 point. Improvising here, so I'm trying to think what this cabin looks like. So I can do it pretty conventional. Again, the cross on any plane in perspective, we'll find your center. So that's how I found that halfway point. That's Robin, you can hear him dreaming. I'm drawing this as a net at the moment, just it helps with building up the structure. So I can find the centre of that back edge, go up through there, and then I've got that pitch for this roof here. I don't need to see through it, but I tend to do that a lot with what I'm drawing. I picture the entire thing. It helps with drawing what you can see, but it's not essential, especially just like a quick drawing like this. There you go, basic forms emerging now. This, I put it amongst some trees. I could put it in a tree. Yeah, let's do that. So to do that, I'm going to add a little bit of a fur, like a, almost turn it into a 3 point now. So my third point will be way down off the page, but I'm just going to start to bring in my verticals leading towards third point lower down off my page, as if you're looking down. So if the third vanishing point is below the horizon, you're looking down. If it's above, you're looking up. This way we can feel a little bit like, I mean, yeah, we can adjust that slightly. Yeah, looking down through the trees, so So it's turning into Treehouse. No, I don't want this to be a really long drawing. It's tempting. It's always a temptation that I start enjoying it a bit too much and then labouring over it. But if I'm going to keep producing these videos, I need to keep them quick because I just don't have the time at the moment. So I'm going to kind of crop this. Am I going to crop it? No, I'm not going to crop the field of vision. I'm going to create a porch area at the front. So again, anything... anything parallel with this set of lines will lead to the same vanishing point. And then the opposing or the perpendicular lines go to this one. Thereabouts. You don't have to worry about being too accurate. We'll do a rope ladder. So as you go further down, you're still the same rule applies. Because these runs on the ladder are all parallel, they're all going to be leading to this vanishing point. I'm being a bit lazy here, but I could find out the halfway section of there. So this height and this height will have the same number of runs on the ladder, but I'm just going to kind of eyeball it on this occasion. Maybe a little bit. Measure a little bit. Yeah, that's all I really need to do. Now I can do it half by eye and then half again. So that's what I do a lot in my drawing. I'll divide and subdivide until more and more detail appears, rather than, you know, starting from one end to the other. This is the best way to stay on proportion and perspective. Yeah, I won't draw much more than that because it's going off the camera, so. So I think I'll focus back on this treehouse cabin type thing. And let's put the door in. So here's another thing you can do, use the cross. Because I've drawn one edge of this door and I want it to be centered on this, I can use that cross, draw back to this vanishing point, and where that line intersects the opposing diagonal will be equidistant in perspective. Hope that makes sense. Basically, this distance is the same as this distance just by using that geometry. I'm going to put a slight arch in there. put a window in this side. Again, find halfway down the plane with the cross technique. Now before, you can see the lines, I was keeping them fairly vertical, but because I've decided that I'm going to have this kind of third vanishing point, I'm gradually bringing them in over time. It's not ideal. You kind of want to know kind of what your plan is before you're establishing the perspective, but for the purpose of this, I think it's fine. Got quite a basic design here. I think it's because I'm tired. So pretty run-of-the-mill rectangular window there. I'll make it a little more crittle-like, so it's a bit more interesting. A bit, not much, a bit. Kind of a tin roof vibe going on there. And then the timber for the construction of the cladding, I'm going to go with horizontal. That's just be a good way to kind of go back to the vanishing points. Oh, a little bit too high there. Just adjust. Call this wany edge timber, especially the way I draw. We do here. I think I'm gonna put like a porch light out the front of this treehouse type thing. So we have a light source. So it's gonna be kind of like an evening. Yeah, I'm gonna make this kind of like a dark scene. So you got the window lit up. I'd quite like to be in this treehouse. So the only shadow you get is from where it's fixed in here, so that'd be going up something like that. I don't know. Let's finish these trees. I won't be able to do these trees justice, I know it, but So another thing is the spatial edge. So of a 3D form, it's good to define this spatial edge, as I'm doing here, a bolder line. This tree running around the front would be lit by this light here. So the shadow on the tree is more going to be to the right. Obviously, not a whole lot of realism going on here, but I think with light it's good to keep some logic. And again here, the left side, because the cabin's our main source of light, the left side is going to be the darkest here. We've got the light coming from that window, which will be less so higher up the tree. Just gradually building this up over time. It's really the only way to do it in terms of the trees, because the appearance of the wood is just through lots and lots and lots of trees, layers and layers, so yeah, it makes sense that the drawing would take form like this as well. Because this is our main light source, I might give this a frame. Yeah, I'm going to frame this just for speed as well, so we have a finished drawing. I'm going to go a bit further down there. Thank you. can be a bit bolder with light, I think. I'm not really going for a haunted vibe, that wasn't my intention. I was thinking more kind of cozy lit cabin in the woods, but it's looking a little bit haunted. I guess it's subjective. Starting to take shape now. Obviously these boulder lines represent the trees, and because of this third point you've got this kind of sweep and they're all leading towards that lower third vanishing point. So again, the vanishing point doesn't need to be on the page. You need to have a sense of where it is. And just playing around like this is a great way to develop that awareness. Talk a lot about that in the perspective foundation videos that I've done. It doesn't just happen. There's no shortcut to that really. Unless you want to do the whole string thing, but I don't think you should rely on that. I think it's much better to have an awareness. It's not easy, I'm still improving and learning. That's the great thing about drawing. Okay, I'm kind of getting the impression that we're in the trees here, somewhat. Needs something there, doesn't it? So, if I work out the trees that are closer to us, I can bring those out. They're in the foreground. Make some of the trees a little more dominant, so there's a bit more hierarchy. That's under the platform, so that'll be really dark. That's the light in it a little bit. And the tree, as it goes down away from you, will be getting narrower as it gets further away, because obviously the main rule in perspective is that things further away appear smaller. It's easy to forget that, get caught up in all the vanishing points and horizon lines. So I'm using a really fine line weight here, it's a 0.05. So it can get a little bit frustrating for tasks like this, but if you use a thicker line weight, you can kind of get there quicker, but then there's less detail within the hatching and all the line work, which I quite like. I quite like that detail. So it's up to you really what medium to use. Graphite would be great because you can just build up tone so much quicker. But yeah, you probably know that I've got a bit of a passion for ink, so I tend to stick with ink. Don't want to lose my rope ladder too much. So I think that's kind of the structure of it, but I'm gonna maybe find a pen that isn't quite so worn out, so I can. What's this one doing? So then I can do the shade more. No, that's not much better. Okay, what's going on? Is it worth the risk? Shall we go for an isograph? Which is not playing today. Come on. This is really thick. Is it all dried up? Oh, here we go. Right, this may ruin the drawing, but maybe not. So going with a thicker line weight, I want the rest, so the perimeter of the drawing, to feel really quite dark, so that will give the sensation that this is lighter. And okay, this has not gone to plan. Okay, third time lucky. What else we got? Oh, I think that'll be too much. Let's see what happens. Oh yeah. Okay, might have overdone it here. This is a brush nib. So I'm going to be really soft with it and see if I can get away with it. But it could just dominate everything. Just wanted to find out. I'm going to zoom out a little. Because we're working on the perimeter. Right. The brush nib is a little bit dry, which I think is helping because I have a bit more control. But again, I'm thinking of the third vanishing point. kind of working. The corners can be pretty much like really dark, I think. I think it can take that. Kind of working, it's a little bit extreme. Okay, not the intention. I'm going to go in bolder to denote the trees now. Well, this has been an interesting experiment, but quite like this brush nib, but maybe not as I'm intending to use it here. It's just dominated everything. But you know, live and learn. My motto is kind of embrace your mistakes, so I can't moan about them on a video, on record. So, yeah, I mean, I think it's kind of interesting, this drawing. I think I preferred it earlier on, and I think if I'd have just maybe been a little less lazy and just refilled the ink on the original pen, I could have been really happy with it, but it's good to try out some different pens and nibs, see the limitations. It looks like, the problem with this, it almost looks like two separate drawings, but that's okay. I keep telling myself that's okay. It's strange using the brush nib to shade rather than hatching. There's less control. That might be a good thing. Do you like that you can go from some making really broad marks to really wispy, fine ones? Okay, I'm gonna go even darker in the corners. Just means a bit more tonal range. That's helped it. Again, main thing is I'm having fun with it, so. Yeah, this is definitely haunted. This is not so relaxing and cozy as intended. Okay, again, we're drawing 36 minutes now. I need to go to bed. This is only meant to be 20 minutes max. But I am drawing it, so I guess that's the point, isn't it? Good old Inktober. But I've pretty much got until I hear crying coming from upstairs. From my baby, not from my girlfriend. That'd be weird. Shall I stop? What's this one doing now? It woken up. The isograph, you really need to look after it and make sure they're not left alone because I don't like it. They are lovely though when they're working. Really black ink. The Copic's great, but the ink's a little bit grey. Which I'm not a huge fan of. Yeah, no, this needs cleaning and re-inking. Okay, I think I'm going to stop. That was good. I enjoyed that. Again, the result is a little bit strange, but it's more hovering, isn't it? Hovering in the trees, because it's not really coming into contact much with trees. Maybe I should have had a big tree going through it or something. To be revised. But hopefully you found it helpful. You know, we drew the cube in 2-point and then kind of drew its surroundings in 3-point perspective, which meant we had to kind of modify the original form a little bit, which, you know, you do have to find, you do find yourself doing that sometimes. Sometimes your initial reading of the perspective, how you'd like it, is wrong, so you have to adjust slightly. Yeah, it's kind of weird, but I like that. Oh my god, oh my god, I need to sort the pens out. I need to go to bed, but thanks for watching. And let me know if you found that helpful. If you didn't, you don't really have to let me know that. That's okay. You can just, yeah, you don't have to let me know. But yeah, the brush nib was actually quite fun. I think if I'd planned it in, I could have made it work a little bit more. The cabin Treehouse. I'd quite like to stay there, but I don't think it's structurally attached to everything, anything even, so probably not a good idea. So yeah, I hope you found it helpful. And as exciting as Robin did, because she's had a ball, you know. Number one fan over there. All right, Inktober day 3.